Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And in this video, we are going to talk about the freelancing platforms like Upwork, Freelancer, Fiverr, etc. and whether or not you should be using them as a newbie freelancer. Now, when you're going to go on the internet and search about freelancing, the first thing that's going to come up is recommendations of using Upwork, Elance, Freelancer, Guru, and all these kind of freelancing platforms. But I know that there are a lot of questions around them. Should you use them? Are they good enough to be used right now? Aren't they overcrowded? How to set yourself apart? There are just so many questions that must be going on in your head. And in this video, I'm going to address all of them. By the end of this video, you will know exactly what you need to do. So stick with me till the end. Hi guys, I'm Chavi, a freelancer, a blogger, a YouTuber, and an online business coach. I create videos on making money online and freelancing each and every week. So if you haven't already, click on the red icon below and subscribe to my channel. Now let's get started. Now there is one thing that I want to be upfront about. I haven't personally used Upwork or Fiverr as a freelance writer. Now I do have an Upwork profile because a lot of people recommended Upwork. A lot of people were making money on Upwork. I saw that it has been marketed well. I saw a lot of good reviews about Upwork, so I obviously wanted to try it out as a freelance writer. And I created that profile, but within, I think, 48 hours, I quit. I stopped using those platforms because of several reasons that we are going to talk about in this video. Now, I have used Fiverr and Upwork, both of them, for hiring freelancers for my business, and I have quit that as well because my experience wasn't good with either one of them. So I'm going to share about all of this, and we are going to begin with the positive side of using any of these freelancing platforms. And the one positive thing that I feel and that I see on these platforms is that it is giving you a launch platform to launch your freelancing business. It's getting you in front of people, in front of potential clients that are already hiring. That means it's cutting down a lot of work that you have to do as an independent business owner, as an independent freelancer. You don't have to market your services. You don't have to create a personal brand. You don't have to use Instagram, Facebook groups, LinkedIn, Pinterest, any of the social media. You don't have to apply to job boards outside of these platforms. So it's cutting a lot of work that you have to do as an independent business owner. You also don't have to take care of payments because that's what these platforms take care of. But for all the things that it's providing you, it's also taking away a lot of things from you. If you're going to talk about the negatives, there are just so many of them. The first one is that it is an overcrowded platform. In fact, Upwork has stopped admitting new freelancers to its platform because they have just so many and there is a wait list. So whenever a new job ad has been posted on any of these freelancing platforms, people hop onto it and there are like thousands of proposals within a few hours. And that's what I experienced when I launched my first job ad on Upwork. There were just so many proposals. And people were ready to do it at a really, really low cost. And that's what makes it extremely difficult to set yourself apart in such a crowd. It's an overcrowded platform. It has just so many freelancers wanting to do something for $5, for $10, that it's not going to become a full-time job for you if that's what you want with freelancing. And like I said, the second problem with this platform is that you cannot set yourself apart. It is extremely difficult to differentiate yourself because you have to follow a protocol. There are only just so many things that you can do on Freelancer and Fiverr and Upwork as compared to using social media where you can create personal brand, create authority, create credibility, share a lot of value, and then attract clients by many inbound and outbound marketing tactics. You can't do that on these platforms, and that's what makes it extremely difficult to land clients as a beginner without any reviews, without any experience, without a great portfolio. The third problem is that whenever you're going to see a job that you're interested in, you are supposed to use your credits and bid on that project with a proposal. Now what happens is that you are forced to bid low on these projects because that's what other freelancers are doing. As a new freelancer who's underconfident about their skills, about the rates, they're forced into this system and they're forced to charge low, which ultimately annoys you and which ultimately makes you feel that freelancing cannot be your full-time job, which is completely wrong. And the fourth and the most important thing is that they take away a huge percentage of your earnings. Now, you can see it on the screen. This is the fee structure of Upwork. So for $0 to $500, they're going to take away 20% of your earning. From $500 to $1,000, they're going to take 10%. Now, let me clarify one thing which you would have missed out when I was talking about the fee structure. Now, if you land a client which is $600, they're going to take 20% on the first $500. That becomes $100. And for the next $600 to $1,000, they're going to charge another 10%. That would make in total $110 for that client that is paying you $600, which means you're going to get only $490. Now, if you're going to land this exact same client outside of the platform, you're going to make $110 more, which is a huge amount of money, right? So that is one of the reasons that I recommend using social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, Facebook groups, and LinkedIn to find clients independently. It might take a little bit more time, but you're going to make a lot more money with the client that you find independently. See, when you're going to start out as a freelancer, you're not going to find your client, your first client, immediately if you have no experience, if you are not extremely, extremely good at your services that you're providing. It's going to take some time to land a client. You need to be patient and you should not give up. What you need to focus on is to create credibility. Create your authority, use the social media platforms, market your services, talk more about it so that the potential client knows that you're available for hire, that you have the kind of services that they want and you are in their budget. This is something very important as a freelancer. You need to market yourself. You cannot shy away from that. You need to sell your services, okay? And you need to keep patience. But after all of this, if you still want to use Upwork, if you still want to use Fiverr, there are a few tips that I want to give you. The first thing is to use all the features that these platforms are offering you. Use everything to showcase your skills, your relevant experience, your relevant education, and anything relevant that you want to put out there to convince your client that you are the right fit for the job. If there is a title to anything, title to your profile, title to your gig, make sure it is crisp, nothing too smart, nothing too witty, and it has a keyword. So let's say that I can create an ebook for you. I can edit wedding videos. Something very specific so that when a client reads it, they know exactly what they can expect from you. If there's a description, use it to highlight what you can do, for whom you can do, what sets you apart, is there any relevant experience, if there is any results that you have driven, if there are something that you are offering that nobody else has. So let's say if you're a content writer, you can offer SEO optimization, keyword research, competition analysis, a lot of other things that no other freelancer is offering on that platform. Make sure that you're highlighting all of it. You are using bold, italics, highlights, and highlighting each and every part of your description that your client needs to see. You need to make it extremely visible so that your client does not have to read paragraphs, but they can cursor through and know exactly why they should hire you. It is extremely important that you do this. If there is an FAQ feature on any of these platforms, I know Fiverr has it, use it. Use it to address concerns like what is your experience, the turnaround time, the kind of questions that you're getting from your clients regularly. Put it in your FAQs because that's going to really help you out. That's going to differentiate you from other freelancers on the platform. Now, the next thing is that use their three-tier pricing system. Fiverr has it. I think Upwork also has it. So make sure that you're using all three of them, giving your clients options that they can avail. So add a few features to each one of them and add a few more bucks to each of your gigs when you are creating any of these freelancing gigs on these platforms. If you are sending a proposal or if you're pitching any client on these platforms, make sure that you're personalizing your pitch and talking about something that has relevance that shows that you're the perfect fit. So if you have a specific experience in that, if you have a skill, if you have specific education, if you've worked with the client, if you have driven some kind of results, showcase that, highlight that. It's extremely important. And the last thing is that don't just restrict yourself to Upwork and Fiverr. Promote your profiles on these freelancing platforms on social media as well. Use Facebook, use LinkedIn, use Instagram, and showcase that you're available for hire on these platforms so that your clients can trust you more, so that your clients can actually go on that platform, hire you, pay you through the platform, and give you reviews. Now, reviews are also extremely important on these platforms because that's what creates credibility and trust in the first moment that your client is going to look at your profile. So make sure that whoever you work with gives you a review. So these are just some of the tips that can help you stand out as a freelancer on freelancing platforms like Upwork and Fiverr. I still do not recommend them because there are multiple ways to find clients outside of these platforms. You will find higher paying gigs, you will find better clients, high paying clients, and you can make a full-time income with freelancing if you're going to get outside of these platforms and focus your time, money, and effort on something that helps you create an online business, which is sustainable in the longer term, which is not dependent on any platform. Now, if you are interested in freelancing, guys, I'm going to leave a link below. It's my free training on how to start freelancing. I also have a paid course where I coach my students personally on how they can build their freelancing business. I'm going to leave a link to that also. So go check it out if you're interested. I hope this video helped you out. There are two more videos on the screen right now which talks about freelancing. So if you're interested, go check that out. And don't forget to hit the red icon below and subscribe to my channel, guys. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.